In 2018, 1.3 million people finished a marathon in one of over 5,000 events that were held worldwide that year. From a physiological perspective, the marathon is a particularly intriguing challenge of human performance. At the start of the race, your endocrine system releases a surge of adrenaline, which will increase your heart and respiratory rates. Your heart will have to pump 3 to 4 times the amount of blood around your body during a marathon than when you are resting. This blood and the oxygen it carries will go to where it is needed, so away from your digestive system towards your muscles. Those muscles will generate large amounts of heat, 30 to 40 times more than normal, as they repeatedly contract, propelling you forward over the 40,000 steps that you will take during the race. To control your core body temperature, blood will be shunted to the skin surface, and as you sweat, heat will be drawn away from your body. Over the entire course of the marathon, you will lose 3 to 6 liters of sweat. You will burn about 100 calories every mile, so by the time you hit mile 20, your glycogen stores will become low, and provided you haven't been taking on any extra fuel during the race, your main energy source will transition over to fat. Whereas your muscular system can only store about 2,000 calories of glucose in the form of glycogen, it has nearly 100,000 calories in its fat stores. But breaking down fat for energy is much slower than carbohydrate and relies on a different energy system. The marathon will test that too. Late in the race, the body can reach a tipping point. It can't supply oxygen to your muscles quickly enough, or it may become anaerobic. Lactate forms and poisons your muscles, and in those muscles, innumerable microtears will have developed. You might be getting too hot. Your glycogen reserves could be close to empty. You start to slow down. This, in a nutshell, is the peripheral model of fatigue, which has also been referred to as the homeostatic limitation model and the catastrophe model.